Floyd Gottschall algorithm. What am I saying by it? I'm just mentioning that I have some nodes, some graph, which are being connected and have some weight x, y, z. Now I'm trying to find a path from node 1 to node 2, node 1 to node 3, node 1 to node 4. I'm trying to find a path from 1 to 2, 1 to 3, and 1 to 4, which is shortest in terms of the total weight of the edges on the path. That is called as the distance of the path. So how can I reach 2 in minimum possible manner? It is possible that I can reach from 1 to 2, or is it possible I can reach 1, 4, 3, 2 in a possibly shorter path depending from graph to graph. So I have to search for that shortest path. In all pair shortest path algorithm, I have not only to find from 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, I have also to find from 2 to 1, 2 to 3, and 2 to 4. Similarly, I have to find 3 to 2, 3 to 1, 3 to 2, and 3 to 4, and similarly, 4 to 1, 4 to 2, and 4 to 3, what are the shortest path? Since I am considering a directed path, 1 to 2 is not the same path as 2 to 1. 1 to 2 and 2 to 1 are separate paths in that case. So I'll be trying to explain you the algorithm, that is Floyd Warshall's algorithm for all pair shortest path algorithm. Now what we are trying to do here in the Floyd Warshall's algorithm, we are just... Sorry, just excuse me for this. What we are trying to do over here is, we are just trying to take an example and we'll try to solve the example first so that we understand the steps, and then we'll try to see what the algorithm is and how the execution goes. So just taking an example that supposedly I have a graph 1 which is having 4 nodes. In case anybody is unable to understand, please stop me there and then and ask the doubts. So I have a graph having 4 nodes, 1, 2, 3, and 4, connected with some edges which I'm just drawing, and weight of the edges I'm mentioning. I'll request you to please mute your voices in case you are not asking a question. Supposedly, this is a graph which I am having. So, we have to find the minimum distance from 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, similarly from other nodes and so on. So, first I create a distance matrix D. Distance matrix D. D0 I am calling it initially. The initial distance matrix represents... It is of the order n cross n. For n number of nodes in the graph, the size of the matrix is n cross n. Since there are 4 nodes in the graph, so here we will be having 4 rows and 4 columns for us. How do I enter the elements in the graph? It represents the distance. Distance from 1, 2, 3, 4 to 1, 2, 3, and 4. The distance from node 1 to node 1 is 0. Distance from node 2 to node 2 is 0. Distance from node 3 to node 3 is 0. And distance from node 4 to node 4 is 0. So the main diagonal of my distance matrix is always 0, as this represents the distance of a node from itself. So the minimum possible distance of a node from itself is always 0. Hence this remains 0. Next, we will try to see what are the edges and we'll try to put the weight of the edges in the distance matrix. So 1 to 2, if you see, 1 to 2 is an edge with weight 3. So row 1, column 2, the distance initially is 3. I'm taking the edges. Then 2 to 1 is 8. 2 to 1 initially is 8. Similarly, 1 to 4 is 7. And 1 to 3, there is no edge. There is no edge, no outgoing edge from node 1 to node 3. So the distance from 1 to 3 is taken infinitely. Now the distance from 2 to 3. 2 to 3 is again infinite since there is no edge from 2 to 3. The distance from 2 to 4 is again infinite as there is no edge directly connecting from node 2 to node 4. Now, distance from 3 to 1 is 5, 3 to 2 is 2, 3 to 4 is 1. Distance from 4 to 1 is 2, 4 to 2 there is no edge, so infinite. 4 to 3 there is no edge, so again infinite. Is the initial distance matrix clear to all of you? Please,
yes, ma'am.
Let me know in case there is any doubt. So this is the initial distance matrix. Now from this distance matrix, I will be creating distance matrices for all the four nodes. And the last matrix will give me all pair shortest paths. Now, what is happening now, what we'll be doing is, we try to see whether if inserting node 1 in between the paths reduces the cost of the path. If I'm having a direct node from 3 to 2, if I try to reach 3 to 1 and 1 to 2, is the cost reduced? Similarly, I have 3 to 4. If I go 3, 1, 4, is the cost reduced? I will keep on checking. That is a dynamic programming approach. I go step by step and I'm using the same formula at every step to correct my given distances. So I'll just tell you what this distance matrix 1 represents, that I'm trying to insert node 1 in between two nodes. Inserting node 1. So distance matrix when I'm creating for node 1, the diagonal elements again remain 0. Now since I'm going to insert node 1 in between, the first row and first column will remain same as the initial distance matrix. So I'm just copying the first row and the first column as it is. They do not change. These will not be changing. After writing these, I have to calculate, suppose this spot first. This represents 2, 3. 2, 3 is this element. So I have to find 2, 3. For that, what I'm doing in the previous matrix, I am checking that this element 2, 3, whatever the value is this value greater than, now I will be inserting the node 1 in between them. So when I'm inserting them, 1 in between, that means I check 2 to 1, the distance of going from 2 to 1 plus the distance of going from 1 to 3. So the node 1 has been inserted in between 2. So path which I am considering is 2 to 1 and then 1 to 3. Initial value of D 2 to 3 is infinite. So I am checking whether this infinite is greater than 2 to 1. 2 to 1 I can reach in distance 8. And 1 to 3. 1 to 3 again the distance is infinite. So I am checking infinite greater than infinite. I cannot check that. So this distance remains infinite. I am not changing it. Similarly, for the next node, that is 2, 4, I am checking whether the value in the original matrix by inserting 1 in between 2 and 4, whether the original value is greater than if I am trying to find the path by inserting 1. So again, I'm trying to find the values. Initial value of D2 to 4 is again infinite. D2 to 1 is 8. And D1 to 4 is 7. So I'm trying to check whether infinite is greater than 15. Yes, it is greater. So I am going to put the minimum value in my next matrix. So I am going to relax the distance between the node 2 to 4 and I will insert the value, update the value 15 here. Is it clear how am I updating 15? Similarly, if I have to find this value, that is 3, 2. If I have to find the value 3, 2, in that case, I will check whether the initial value of 3, 2 is greater than insert 1 in between 3 and 2. So 3 to 1 and 1 to 2. Again, I will be checking the value. 3 to 2 initially is 2. Is 2 greater than 3 to 1 is 5 plus 1 to 2 is 3. So is 5 greater than 8? Oh, sorry, 2 greater than 8? This is false. Since this is false, I will not update it. I keep the minimum value. So I retain 2. Similarly, if I am trying to find the value of the element 3, 4, I take 3 to 1 and 1 to 4. Now 3, 4, the value is 1. 3, 1 is 5. And 1, 4 is 7. So I am trying to see whether 1 is greater than 12. Of course not. I retain the value 1. Now for the last row, I will be checking for element 4 to 2. I am trying to find the path now. Again, insert 1 in between 4 and 2. So I have 4 to 1 and 1 to 2. The initial value of 4 to 2 is 4 to 2 is infinite. The value of 4 to 1 is 2. And the value of 1 to 2 is 3. So I am checking whether infinite is greater than 5. Yes, it is greater than 5. So I will be putting the minimum value here. Similarly, the last element in the matrix, I will be checking 4 to 3. Insert 4 to 1 and 1 to 3, I will be checking. 4 to 3 is again infinite. 4 to 1 is 2. And 1 to 3 is again infinite. So I am checking between infinite, the value remains infinite. I am not going to update this. So this becomes my matrix after trying to insert 1 in between. Till here, is it clear to all? Yes, no? I will be rubbing this matrix till here.
Yes, ma'am.
If you're having any doubt, then please let me know. Now, I will create the matrix D2. I am creating the matrix D2. For creating the matrix D2, again, what will I do? Copy the second row and second column as it is. So, second row of the previous matrix, not D0. Now, D1 becomes the previous matrix. So, second row and second column are copied as it is. That is 3, 0, 2, 5 remains same. And 8, 0, infinite and 15 remains same. Now, the other values and the diagonal elements remain 0. Other values have to be calculated. Fine. So, for calculating the other values, again, I use the absolute same formula. I will try to insert 2 in between the nodes and try to find whether a shorter path is possible. So the first element that I'm trying to look at is D1, 3 I'm trying to find out. Again, I have to check, insert 2 in between them. So check D1, 2 plus D2, 3. 2 has been inserted between 1 and 3. After this, I will be checking. So, D1, 3 initially is infinite. Whether infinite is greater than 1, 2 is 3. And 2, 3 is again infinite if you see. So, infinite greater than infinite, I'm stuck at this again. It remains infinite here also. Fine. Then I move on to the next 1, 4. Again, insert 2 between 1 and 4. And try to check for the values. So I check for the values. 1, 4 initially was 7. I am trying to see whether 7 is greater than 1, 2 is 3. Plus 2, 4 is 15. So I am trying to say 7 greater than 18. False. I will keep the value 7. So there are no changes here. Then I come to this 3, 1. 3, 1 is 5 initially. I have to check for 3, 1. Insert 2 in between. So I check 3 to 2 and 2 to 1. 3 to 1 is initially 5. 3 to 2 initially is 2. And 2, 1 is initially 2, 1 is initially 8. So I am checking 5 greater than 10 is again false. Since this is false again, 5 retains its value. I am checking for 1. 1 se to kuch bada hoga nahi, so 1 will be retained. Similarly, I am checking for 2. 2 is the smallest. Now supposedly I'm checking for this element. I have D4 comma 3. Insert a 2 in between. Go from 4 to 2 and 2 to 3. So the initial value of 4 comma 3 is infinite. Initial value of 4 to 2 is 5. And initial value of 2 to 3 is infinite. I still remain at infinite. Is there some error that we have done? No, we are correct here, okay? We're still reaching correctly till here. Now, we are trying to reach from 4 to node 3. There is actually no path in this graph which is possible. So that distance remains infinite. If you see, if you try to see from the arrows, I can reach from 4 to 1, I can reach from 1 to 2. There is no possibility of reaching from 2 to 3, the example that has been taken. So that remains like this. This process continues till I create the matrix D4. The same process continues for creating matrix D3 and D4. Whatever will be the values in D4, they give me the shortest path between all the pair of nodes. Is that clear to all of you? These you can create on your own? Or do I need to do them? Are you all listening? Class? You students are there or not? I am saying D3 and D4 can be created in similar manner, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So since they can be created, now I try to derive the formula which I have been using. What formula I have been using? D matrix, distance matrix for kth element and the value I comma j of the matrix. This is what we have been trying to find out. This is actually equal to, in the algorithmic terms, this is equal to the minimum value in between. I'm trying to find the minimum in between D of k minus 1, previous matrix, and insert k in between I comma k, initial value of I comma j. And is this value shorter or the value obtained after inserting k, that is I comma k plus the value of k comma j. So whatever value is shorter will be inserted in the matrix. This is the formula that we are using for insertion. So we have derived the formula. Is the formula clear to all? Class. Are you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Now if I try to write a code for the same, what do I have to do? I'll just show you how to write a code. This is the algorithmic term. Now if I try to write this in the terms of code, so for n cross n matrix, I will be having two loops, one for I, one for j. So I'm having two for loops. For I is equal to say 1. I is running till the number of nodes, I plus plus. And I'm having for j is equal to 1, j less than equal to n, j plus plus. Right? Now here what am I doing? I am considering the same matrix and I am rewriting in the same matrix. So D of I, J, this value is actually is equal to the minimum found between D of I, J and D of I, K plus D of K, J. So whatever will be the minimum value, that should be inserted here. Now what is k? How is k varying? K is varying for all the nodes. We are deriving D1, D2, D3, D4. Distance matrix is calculated for all the nodes. So I have another loop which is running from k is equal to 1, k less than equal to n, and k plus plus. This becomes my code for writing the Floyd Borshall's algorithm or all pair shortest path algorithm. Is this clear to all? Is there any doubt, anybody? If you clearly see, I have three for loops running till n. So the complexity of the algorithm becomes big O of n into n into n. That becomes O n cube, or in strictly if I am saying that it is theta n cube. The complexity becomes theta n cube. Till here, is anybody is having any doubt, then please ask.